So I told you, we were at about the challenges to and restoration of the Congress system. And I told you about the challenges of political succession and all. Here in the screen, again, I little bit recapture with you. You know, Prime Minister Nehru passed away in May 1964, I told you. And after that, there was a big question that people used to think that who will be after Nehru. Up now, after the passing away of Nehru, then one topic is Nehru to Shastri. The ease with which the succession after Nehru took place proved all the critics wrong. It means lot of people, they used to think that who will be the leader of India. And the critics used to say that India will be divided into many parts because no one is there, no one is able leader is there. But they were proved wrong. When Nehru passed away, K. Kamraj, the president of the Congress party, consulted party leaders and Congress members of the parliament and found that there was a consensus in favor of Lal Bahadur Shastri. They were consensus in the favor of Lal Bahadur Shastri. He was unanimously chosen as the leader of the Congress Parliamentary Party and thus became the country's next prime minister. Shastri was non-controversial leader from Uttar Pradesh who had been a minister in Nehru's cabinet for many years. Nehru had come to depend a lot on him in his last year. He was known for his simplicity. And who was known for his simplicity? Shastri was known as simplicity and his commitment to principles. Earlier, he had resigned from the position of railway minister, accepting the moral responsibility for a major railway accident. Just you can see, you can think about that now the people who, if some railway accident is there, then nobody bothers about it, right? No ministers resign. No ministers take responsibility that what is happening. Right, he used to say there's the one committee will be there who will take the serious allegation of the lapses of security of railway passengers. Then after some time, we all forget. Nobody took responsibility, but Shastri took responsibility that he is a railway minister. So he moral responsibility is that why there was an accident, I took moral responsibility and he resigned. So that's why he was known for the simplicity. Shastri was the country's prime minister from 1964 to 1966. And in his brief prime ministership, the country faced two implications of the war, which are failed monsoons, drought, in the previous chapter. Also, we face crisis. The country also faced a war with Pakistan in 1965. Now, Shastri became the prime minister, he had to face a lot of challenges. We have already discussed this, challenges did Mr. Shastri face. First topic was what the challenge was, that first aggression by China in India. There was a war between India and China before 1962 में हुआ था, पर उसकी इम्प्लीकेशंस चाइना की जो वॉर की इम्प्लीकेशन थी 1965 में भी एक्सेप्ट किया गया, बिकॉज चाइना गेव अ गुड थ्रेशिंग जॉल्ट टू इंडियाज डिफेंस एंड इंडियाज सिक्योरिटी. 62 में 19 वी हैड ड्यूरिंग द टेन्योर ऑफ नेहरू India had a war, or China gave a war threatening of had a war with India. India surrendered, and you know, India was defeated by China in 1962. The implication continued for 2 or 3 or 4 years. Still, its implications are there. 1965 came. Now, in 1965, war with Pakistan. Drought situation was also there. Right, drought matlab sukha. Sukha, sorry. Drought situation was also there. Failed monsoons were also there. Monsoons were failed. And food crisis was also there. So there were lot of challenges from every side. And food crisis presented a grave challenge as discussed in the previous chapter. The country also faced a war with Pakistan, I told you just now, in 1965. Shastri's famous slogan, Jai Jawan, Jai Kisan. You know, still it's a very famous slogan, Jai Jawan, Jai Kisan. Shastri's very famous slogan, Jai Jawan, Jai Kisan. And they are serving the land with food and all. So Jai Jawan was a very popular slogan given by Shastri. Shastri came to an abrupt end in January 10, 1906, when he expired in Tashkent. Tashkent is in sudden death. Ho gaya. And let me tell you one thing. Many people say that it was not a death. It was not a simple death. It was not a natural death. He was being killed. It is said by many, you know, it's a news by many TV, also television also, that Shastri was an heart attack. Had an heart attack when he suddenly expired in Tashkent. It is in USSR. And currently, Uzbekistan, divided from, you know, USSR, another country, small country, Uzbekistan, and it is their capital is Tashkent. He was there to discuss and sign an agreement with Muhammad Ayub Khan, the president of Pakistan. Pakistan say, you know, requested counterpart of USSR that, you know, you should say India to stop the aggression, and they are ready to sign the treaty. And Muhammad Ayub Khan, and there was a treaty between Muhammad Ayub Khan and, you know, Lal Bahadur Shastri, and the result was the war, the end of the war. So, humne yahan pe teen cheezein padhi. First, the critics, they were wrong. They were thinking that India will plunge into deep crisis. The India mein bahut badi crisis hone wali hai. Kyunki after Nehru, nobody knows who will be the prime minister. But critics were wrong. Shastri became the prime minister. When Shastri became the prime minister, there were a lot of challenges from many sides. Challenges, the, you know, restoration of peace and cool and calm atmosphere, because, you know, the people were still thinking about 1962 war with China. We had to face humiliation in the hands of China. 65 came. Then war with Pakistan. Then, you know, natural calamity, drought were there. And, you know, failed monsoons were there. Food crisis was there. But he gave a one slogan, Jai Jawan, Jai Kisan, to come up from these challenges. And in 1966, he had a, you know, pact with Muhammad, the President Muhammad Ayub Khan of Pakistan. After that, he suddenly died. Chapter came up to an end of Shastri. Now, I told, chapter is very interesting, you know, from Nehru to Shastri. From the earlier first Prime Minister was Nehru. From Nehru to Shastri, second Prime Minister was Shastri. And third Prime Minister was Mrs. Indira Gandhi. From Nehru to Shastri, and now Shastri to Mrs. Indira Gandhi. Here it is on your screen. Thus, the Congress faced the challenge of political succession for the second time in 2 years. This time, there was an intense competition between Morarji Desai and Indira Gandhi. Let me tell you one thing and a very interesting thing also. Morarji Desai also became the Prime Minister, you know, Morarji Desai. He was also the Prime Minister of India. So this time, there was an intense competition between Morarji Desai and Indira Gandhi. Morarji Desai had earlier served as Chief Minister of Bombay State, today's Maharashtra and Gujarat, and also the Minister of Center. Indira Gandhi, the daughter of Jawaharlal Nehru, had been Congress President in the past and also had been Union Minister for Information in Shastri's cabinet. Look now, though these two people, Morarji Desai was also cabinet minister, and Mrs. Indira Gandhi was also cabinet minister. Mr. Morarji Desai was the chief minister of Gujarat and Mumbai, right? Mrs. Indira Gandhi was the information minister. Indira Gandhi, the daughter of Jawaharlal Nehru, had been Congress president. She was the Congress president also, and Union Minister of Information in Shastri's cabinet. This time, senior leaders in the party decided to back Mrs. Indira Gandhi. You know, she was having a very charismatic personality, flamboyant personality. Senior leaders, they supported Mrs. Indira Gandhi. And this time, the senior leaders also supported Mr. Indira Gandhi, but the decision was not unanimous. The contest was resolved through a secret ballot among Congress MPs. Indira Gandhi defeated Morarji Desai. Now, some people, they were supporting Morarji Desai. Some people, they were supporting Mrs. Indira Gandhi. The majority, they supported Mrs. Indira Gandhi. Now, there was a secret, there was a secret ballot. Ek chunav hua, secret. You know, many, just few people know that there is going to be some secret ballot in which Mrs. Indira Gandhi defeated Mr. Morarji Desai. The contest was resolved through a ballot among Congress MPs. Indira Gandhi defeated Morarji Desai by securing the support of more than two-thirds of the party's MPs. A peaceful transition of power, despite intense competition for leadership, was seen as a sign of maturity of India as a democracy. Ab jiske paas zyada chunav ka pal raha tha, right, Mr. Indira Gandhi was the winner. Is the transfer to Indira Gandhi, and Mr. Morarji Desai accepted defeat. So this is the essence of DNA. This was in Indian democracy. It means democracy. So it took some time before the new prime minister could settle down. While Indira Gandhi had been politically active for a long time. Now this is a cartoon in which Mrs. Indira Gandhi is standing on a podium. She's one number is there that she is being chosen. She's the just everybody likes her, right? And she's number one prime minister. So it took some time before the new prime minister could settle down. While Indira Gandhi had been politically active for very long, she had served as a minister under Lal Bahadur Shastri only for a short period. The senior Congress leaders may have supported Indira Gandhi in the belief that her administrative and political inexperience would compel her to be depend on them for support and guidance. Within a year of becoming prime minister, Indira Gandhi had to lead the party in Lok Sabha election. Right, now listen to me very carefully. Many Congress party leaders, they supported Mrs. Indira Gandhi for two points. First, she was the daughter of Jawaharlal Nehru. Right, everybody have a sympathy for her. Second thought was that she is an immature political leader, not very experienced, and she will be depending on the other leaders. So those leaders who thought that they will do whatever they want to do with the help of Mrs. Indira Gandhi, they supported her. समझ आ गया ना आपको? तो उन्होंने सोचा था कि कई लीडर्स ने सोचा था कि यदि वो मिसेज इंदिरा गांधी को सपोर्ट करेंगे तो बहुत सारी बातें वो मिसेज इंदिरा गांधी से मनवा पाएंगे, वो अपनी चलाएंगे. मिसेज इंदिरा गांधी कुछ कर नहीं पाएंगी बिकॉज शी इज एन इनएक्सपीरियंस्ड लीडर. अराउंड दिस टाइम द इकोनॉमिक सिचुएशन in the country had further deteriorated. Adding to her problems, faced with these difficulties, she set out to gain control over the party and to demonstrate her leadership skills. Kuch aur problems aa gaye Mrs. Indira Gandhi ke raaste mein, and she was able to, you know, fight with those difficulties, those problems. She was able to control over the party and party leaders. She was able to demonstrate her leadership skills. She was able to demonstrate her leadership skills. Now, there is a small yellow part in which it is given an introduction to Mrs. Indira Gandhi. Introduction of Mrs. Indira Gandhi. She was born in 1917. She died in 1984 by the terrorist attack. She was killed by the Sikh terrorist in New Delhi. Prime Minister of India from 1966 to 77. Then again 1980 to 84, Dr. Jawaharlal Nehru participated in freedom struggle as a young Congress worker. Congress president in 1958, minister in Shastri cabinet from 1964 to 66, led the Congress Party to victory in 1967. War with Pakistan in 1971, in 1971 to 1980, general elections credited with the slogan Garibi Hatao. She gave a very good slogan, acceptable slogan, that is Garibi Hatao. Victory, we had a war with Pakistan, that is victory in 1971 war, and for policy initiative like abolition of previous pulse kya hota hai, rajaon ko kuch tankhwa milti thi, pension milti thi rajaon rajkumaron ko, rajkumariyon ko, to band kar diya. Abolition of previous pulse, nationalization of banks, jitne banks usko nationalize kiya gaya. Nuclear test hua, right, and environmental protection, she wants environmental protection, and she was assassinated on 31st of October in 1984. Unko maar dala gaya usko terrorist ne, unhe 1984 mein wo, she died. Now, it was, I told you about a brief bio sketch of Mrs. Indira Gandhi. Now, next part, fourth general election, 1967. Fourth general election kab hue the? 1967 ko hue the. The year, I will give a little bit hint so that you can know what happened in 1967 and general election. The year 1967 is considered a landmark year in India's political and electoral history. In chapter 2, we read about how the Congress Party was dominant political force throughout the country from 1952 onwards. Means 1952 onwards, Congress was the only party which was very strong. This trend was to undergo significant changes with the 1967 election. So fourth election, general election hua tha 1967 ko, and she was again a winner. Right, so 1967 she became another tenure of prime ministership, and previously to recapitulate, I gave you some little bit bio sketch of Mrs. Indira Gandhi from 1917 to 1984. I told you from that she became the prime minister after Lal Bahadur Shastri's death, from Nehru to Shastri. I gave a sketch, I defined you from Nehru to Shastri. When Nehru died, Lal Bahadur Shastri became the prime minister. He gave a slogan, Jai Jawan Jai Kisan. During his tenure, he had to face a lot of challenges. He was able to hold those challenges. And then again, when he died, then again, a question mark was there, who will be the prime minister? Then from Shastri to Mrs. Indira Gandhi. Mrs. Indira Gandhi became the prime minister. Then now again, fourth general election came in 1967. And in fourth general election, she was again the winner as a prime minister. So here we come to an end. Next part, till then, tomorrow I will go for context of elections and all. Do read the chapter thoroughly, whatever I have done with you. Do the homework. Be careful. Be attentive in with your book, with your lesson. Thank you and take care.